this Damn 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 Damn
goes up 10-19 for the Rods and do anything I want to do.
Do anything you want to do. Recorded in 1977 by Eddie and the Hot Rods. We got a fair amount of stick for this cover when it first came out by Aleister Crowley's aficionados. I can't possibly think why. I mean, what nice song we put in a pair of Mickey Mouse ears on his mugshot. I don't know, I mean, look at those eyes. Looks like a road crew at 3 in the morning. Anyway, actually, it's fair to say a fair amount of bad luck befell the band after this, but that's another story. So, the music was written by one of our two guitarists, Graham Douglas, and the words were knocked up by our manager, Ed Titus, on the back of a fat packet, if I remember correctly, in a Red Lion pub in Hammersmith. And when when the song was first played, actually, I wasn't overly convinced because it was a lot slower and more laid back than any of the songs we'd previously recorded. So when we came out from the pub, suitably refreshed, the engineer, by the way, was a young whippersnapper called Steve Lillywhite, when I happened to him. Rather than play the bass line that I originally thought the song might need, which was pretty laid back, I thought I'd try and kind of kick it up a gear. So I played what I fondly called chords, which aren't really what they are called, they're kind of the root note of a song, which in this case is E, together with the fifth note of the chord. So that's the fifth note up in the scale. I use those a lot in my bass playing. They're in Blackout, Beginning the End, etc. So gradually we kicked it up, we laid all these guitars, and it kind of became the fantastic song that it is. One thing that always kind of niggled me a little bit though was the bass sound, because it was a very kind of Steve Lillywhite and Ed took all the top end off it because they said, no, it's far too clangy for a pop song, which of course I vehemently disagree with. I think they're probably right. And they got round me in the end by saying, well, poor John Entwistle doesn't have that dirty bass sound on the records, it's only live. So that's what you heard on the single. It's been covered by all sorts of people, including The Damned, which you may hear a little bit later on. Here we go.